Good morning. This is Mike Bevilacqua calling from the Merrimack Valley, calling from the Merrimack Valley Chamber of Commerce. We're here for another virtual interview series with the Merrimack Valley Chamber's business program. We have a very special guest today. We have Brian Howard of the North Andover Historical Society. Brian, welcome to the show.
Glad to be here.
So Brian, I'm going to get started just by asking you first off, tell people at home what the North Andover Historical Society is, and where is it located, and then we'll get to some of the fun stuff happening right now with the Historical Society.
Sure. All right. The Historical Society is located in the town's historic old center. It's right at the corner of Academy Road and Massachusetts Avenue, and the society has been here since 1913. We were founded by some of the community's leaders in the early part of the 20th century when they recognized the importance of preserving this town's agricultural, industrial, and social history. And since 1913, our mission has been pretty much unchanged. It's to preserve and promote this region's stories, the people, the events that made it special, what sure. really underscores the town's identity. We've been here for well over 100 years, and we're on the cusp of a major reinvention right now. So very excited to be a part of that.
And where are you located also?
Right at the corner of Academy Road and Massachusetts Avenue in the town's old center. Our mailing address is 153 Academy Road. Probably a lot of people will recognize our campus for the former Merrimack Valley Textile Museum, the large brick structure that faces the town common. That's the building that we are expanding, and also we have a complex of buildings right next to it, one being the historic Johnson Cottage, which dates back to the late 1700s. So it's our charge to preserve these buildings and again use them to be a true community resource.
Yeah, Brian, that's amazing. Over 100 years. I mean, I can't imagine all the history that's happened right in North Andover. There's so many amazing things that's happened. A lot of amazing companies, a lot of amazing historical things that have happened right here in our own backyard. And you can find it all at the North Andover Historical Society. Brian, you talked a little bit about the expanding a little bit. How is the North Andover Historical Society expanding, and what exciting news is going on right now?
Well, for a long time, the building next door at 800 Mass Ave was the Merrimack Valley Textile Museum, and then it was the Museum of Printing. When the Museum of Printing moved out several years ago, the building was left empty, and the Historical Society, which has always owned that building, was left with the question of what to do about it. And there were a number of proposals. One of the most controversial was being the conversion of that building into condominiums, which was not adopted, obviously. We finally came to the decision that here's an opportunity for us to renovate this building, expand the Historical Society, enhance our exhibits, build a theater, create a facility which is going to do more than just house our collections. It's going to really truly reflect and promote the community's history and heritage. So we initiated a capital campaign. We've raised over $1 million already. Wow. For the building improvements. And the first phase is almost complete, making that building entirely self-sufficient, getting it off the grid. We've put solar panels on it. We are installing a geothermal heating system. We are initiating some improvements as well to our existing campus, the Johnson Cottage, and our 1931 headquarters building that I'm talking to you from right now. And we're looking to expand our reach by doing this. Our next phase is going to be fitting out the now almost complete building to make it this museum, historical society, retail center, community event center, theater, and a place for people to come and enjoy their time in the context of the history of North Andover and Northeastern Massachusetts.
No, I think that's great. And I'm really looking forward to checking it out once the renovations are complete. Like you said, over 100 years of history right in that one building. I think it's amazing. Brian, tell us what can people expect if they've never been there before? What can people expect when they visit it? What exciting things you have inside? Why should people check it out?
Okay, it's funny you mentioned, you know, why should people come? I've been in the museum field and I ran a county historical society in upstate New York for a long time before I came here. I hear it literally every week. People will come in here and they'll look around and they'll be like, wow, you know, I've lived in town all my life, or I've been walking past this building for 30 years. I never knew what you had here. I didn't know. And our new approach is aimed at dispelling all of those observations, making sure that we are not the best kept secret in town. We need to move this organization from a small, insular, relatively quiet part of the community into being a relevant player in its development for the future and in what's happening here today. So when people come in, they're going to see new exhibits. They're going to see the way that North Andover's past has shaped the town as it exists today, and hopefully get some ideas through our exhibits and through a very active public programming effort, how we can shape and improve our future, not only for this town, but also, again, for this region, and so that people will have a better understanding of where we fit into the narrative of general American history, because there's just so much here. So between the exhibits, again, active programs, we have already dramatically expanded our bookstore and retail operations. So if somebody wants to take a little piece of North Andover or Northeastern Massachusetts history home with them, we have books, we have puzzles, we have other things that they can take home and again, engage in the study of this region's history, which again, underscores so much of what's happening. Even if we aren't aware of it.
Yeah, and I think that's the coolest thing. I mean, you know, people could live here their whole lives and not, you know, walk into your museum and say, the first thing they say is, I never knew that happened here. I never knew this was located here. I never knew this is how it happened. You tell those stories, you put the picture in there, you know, put the picture together for them. And I think that's great to have that history that where they can find out what happened right here in North, you know, right here in their own backyard, right in Northeastern Mass as well. I think that's great. Brian, I'm going to ask you, obviously COVID's going on right now. Your renovations are going on right now. Are you open now? Or are you closed while these things are going on?
Oh, we reopened at the end of July, and we've adopted all of the appropriate safety protocols to ensure that anybody who comes in, whether they're shopping, taking in our exhibits, or we're not doing so much programming now, because of COVID.
Sure.
To make sure that anybody that does come in and utilize our services will remain safe. That includes mandatory masks. We do have hand sanitizer available. We encourage social distancing, all of the typical things that you would expect in this age. But we are open to the public 5 days a week, Tuesday through Friday, 10 to 4, and Saturdays, 10 to 2. We do shut down for winter break between Christmas and New Year's, but we will resume our regular 5 day a week schedule in January, as of January 5th.
I think that's exciting. I'm sorry.
Oh, I should also mention another thing that we have available right now, which we're going to be dramatically expanding when we move next door, are our research capabilities. We do have a full research library that holds books, photographs, other types of images, documents dating back to the 1700s. Again, all related to the history and heritage of the people. And the spaces that have come to define North Andover. Dramatically expanding our library. So students, genealogists, the general public, people who've lived here for years, authors and so on can all come in and utilize our resources. That's a vital part of what we do and always has been.
No, I think that's exciting. And one of the great things I think right now is that you know, during these times where people, you know, don't feel safe going to take a vacation or go on a plane or, you know, travel far, far distances, they can have a great experience right here in their own backyard, right here in North Andover, and check out the Historical Society, have a great day, have almost like the mini vacation one day by checking out the Historical Society. So that's great that you're open and available for the public to check it out. Thanks again for joining us today. I want you to tell everyone at home how they can contact you, how they can contact you, how they can learn more about the Historical Society, how they can set up a tour, you know, what are the details?
A lot of different ways you can reach us. Our phone number is 978-686-4035. You can check out our website, which has recently been revamped. That is northandoverhistoricalsociety.org. Our retail also has an online presence, and that's northandoverhistorical.square.site, S-I-T-E. And you can come in and have a visit Tuesday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. No appointments needed. Saturdays, 10 to 2. I'd be happy to talk with you, greet you, show you around, tell you a little bit more about our plans for next door and how we're going to make this entire campus a true jewel for everybody that loves North Andover and everybody who calls this town home.
Perfect. Well, I appreciate being part of the show today. Anything else you'd like to add before we sign off?
I've been here about a year. I moved here from Central New York, but my roots in Essex County go back to the 1600s. My direct ancestors were some of the earliest settlers of Ipswich back in 1634. So to come here as a relative outsider with roots in this community, I can't tell you how great it's been to get involved in this area, and not once have I felt unwelcome here. This is a great community. There are some wonderful people here. There's a lot of energy, and we want to make sure that we take as much advantage of that as we can, because when we do that, we're benefiting the citizens that we've pledged to serve since 1913.
No, that's great. And we're very fortunate to have you here, taking your knowledge, taking your experience from other museums to right here in our own backyard, North Andover's Historical Society. So thank you again, Brian. We appreciate you being part of this show. We can't wait to check out the museum and have a ribbon cutting once all the renovations are done. But it's definitely an exciting thing. As I mentioned, a great thing to do right now, especially where you can't really go on vacations. You can check it out right now with your family, with your friends. It's a great opportunity. So thank you again, Brian. We appreciate you being part of the show.
Thanks for having me on board.
Perfect. Thanks again. Thank you all for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next time on another edition of the Merrimack Valley Chamber Means Business series. Thank you.